Did you know that 5 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 13? Pretty neat, right? But wait, it gets even better. Also 10 plus 2 plus 1 equals 13, which allows us to state that, brace yourselves, this is wild, 5 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals 10 plus 2 plus 1. Amazing! Well, thanks for watching. See you in the next. But wait, there is more. I am joking, of course. Let me tell you why 13 being 13 is actually worth discussing. Whenever we write an integer, in this case 13, as a sum of positive integers that are weakly decreasing, so repetitions are allowed but not getting larger, we speak of an integer partition and call the summons parts. One popular way of visualizing an integer partition is in the form of a so-called Young tableau, which is a diagram consisting of boxes in which every row corresponds to one part of the partition. While it is not quite the point of this video, it is a very interesting question to determine how many different integer partitions a number like 13 has. These quantities are given by the so-called partition function. For 13, there are in total 101 different integer partitions, all of whose corresponding Young diagrams are currently illustrated. Now let's get to the curious part and consider two different sets of partitions with special properties. For one, let us look at all partitions where all parts are different, no repetitions to numbers of the entries per row. This is satisfied by the highlighted partitions, overall 18 out of the 101. And for the second set, we highlight all partitions where all of the parts are odd, which is also satisfied by 18 out of the 101 partitions. Coincidence? I think not. And neither did Leonhard Euler. Around 1750, he actually proved that for any positive integer n, the number of partitions of n, where all parts are different, is the same as the number of partitions of n where all parts are odd. Euler's proof uses an elegant and useful tool, so-called generating functions, and can even be put in one line, which we could discuss in detail to follow Euler's reasoning. However, it mostly consists of multiplying out products and collecting terms. Nothing too insightful. There is a more visual approach by James W. L. Glaisher from 1883. He constructs a one-to-one correspondence between these two partition families, which then entails that there must be equally many members in each. Starting with a partition with only odd parts, say 5 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, we count how often every part occurs, and rewrite these counts in base 2. Here, part 5 appears twice, 2 in binary is 1, 0. The part 1 appears 3 times, and 3 in binary is 1, 1. For every 1 in the expansion, we multiply the value of the decimal place with the original part. The resulting number is a part in the partition we are looking for. In our example, binary 1, 0 means we get one part, the decimal place has value 2, the part is 5, and so we find a part of size 2 times 5 is 10. Binary 1, 1 means we get two parts, one of size 2 times 1 and one of size 1 times 1. In total, we find 10 plus 2 plus 1, the second partition from before. While this example might be a bit small, it works just as well for larger partitions. For the partition 9 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 3 plus 3 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 of 42, we find... Pause the video in case you want to try and figure it out for yourself first. I'll give you a moment. The part counts are binary 1 times the part 9, binary 1 1 times the part 7, binary 1 0 times the part 3, and binary 1 1 0 times the part 1. Accordingly, the partition we're looking for has parts 1 times 9, 2 times 7, 1 times 7, 2 times 3, 4 times 1, and 2 times 1. This means that the corresponding partition with unique parts is 14 plus 9 plus 7 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2. It is not overly complicated to reverse this procedure. Basically, look at the largest odd factors in all parts and repeat them the correct number of times. Thanks to this construction, we know now that every partition with only odd parts has exactly one counterpart where all parts are different, which, as a consequence, proves Euler's observation that there are always equally many partitions in these special subfamilies. I'll end this video with one final fun fact. The number 22 has exactly 1,002 different integer partitions, a number which my YouTube channel has just surpassed in terms of subscribers. This means a lot to me. Thank you. Let me know in the comments. Would you like to hear more about fun math results that I like? And I also have to ask, what is your favorite integer partition of the number 42? Thanks again for watching, and see you in the next one. Thank you.